Hello everyone, I'm Luke Kneller and this is Best Replays of the Week. This week we have an E75 holding off a wave of enemies, the little tiger who can, and a fine display of scouting from the east. Let's take a look. The first replay this week is a textbook example of scouting from the SEA region. Banzai Attack takes the AMX 1390 onto the Far East Salient to show us how it's done. Banzai charges forward to catch the enemies crossing the railroad, opening fire as soon as the gun is ready. Three shots and a quick retreat before the enemy artillery can lay in an accurate shot. The reload is a good time to quickly check the west, and then it's back to the center for spotting and skirmishing. It would be good to find a target for the remaining rounds, but the E75 is too tough and dangerous. A reload it is then. And anyway, it's not like a scout needs to fire. Spotting the enemies is quite enough. That does look tempting though. It's time to do some damage. The collision slows Banzai down enough for an enemy to get a shot in. However, payback is swift and deadly. Another shot is taken, rush into the E-75's A, but the results are worth it. Enough shells remain to finish off a T-32. The victory is pretty secure now, and Banzai is free to go hunting. The hunch about the SPG position is spot on. The rest of them are here. Fighting a rival AMX uses all remaining shells, so Banzai can't kill the last arty directly. So spotting it for allies will have to do. That just leaves the TD, which blows up moments later. Victory! A very nice display. The passive scouting was very effective, and the active hunting positively deadly. Well done, scouts! Next up, Mr. Wiegand drives a wall of steel called the E75 on Westfield. This tank is famous for its durability, but the enemies have a lot of hard-hitting Tier 10 machines in their lineup. Wiegand takes point and heads west. There's a large enemy force here, but the damaging hit is friendly fire from behind. Watch your shooting, team! Wiegand fights well, doing significant damage and surviving many shells. The allies aren't doing so well though, as they fall one at a time. Now the E75 is practically alone, holding off a third of the enemy team. The wreck of a fallen ally gives some much needed cover. A rival E-75 charges down the hill, and Wiegand has to leave cover for a while to deal with it. Nice shot, but losing the last ally on this flank is a major blow. Wiegand is left facing three enemies alone, and now it's 2 against 5 for the whole map. There's nothing to be done but to dive in and try to even the odds. The first attempt goes badly, the intended target gets away, and the last hit point buffer is gone. That's better, 1 down, 2 to go. The remaining ally shows up and helps in dismantling the E-50. It's 2 versus 3 now. All premium shells are gone, but the IS-7 is showing its weak side. 2 against 2. Hold on, object, help is coming! Or not. Damn. The E-75 reverses back into cover, but the enemies have decided to cap. We can trust that the enemies don't actually want to win with a cap, and it proves to be true. They are coming. And here's the first one. The AMX 30B loses the first exchange, but takes out Wiegand's trap. It's not repaired in time, and the next shot ends the game in a loss. Oh! But what a fight! You can't win them all. But Mr. Wiegand really gave it the old college try. Better luck next time, Steel Wool. Confederates do their best regardless of the battle tier. Gorazias' Porsche Tiger is a little out of its league in the next fight, but it goes fearlessly after every target it can see. The map is Sacred Valley, and the Tier 9 encounter battle was fought on an EU server. There are only 4 bottom tier machines in the fight, and all the others are light and fast. But so what? Gorazias follows half of the team north and fires on the first enemy unfortunate enough to show itself. After a few exchanges, it's clear that the armor of the Tiger P means nothing against these opponents. On the other hand, the enemies don't seem to pay much attention to the bottom tier heavy. The Tiger's gun doesn't do much damage on this tier, but it has accuracy and penetration. Gorozaius keeps hitting enemy after enemy, gaining no kills, but doing plenty of damage. And all of a sudden, there's just a single enemy left. Gorozaius dives in and scores the hit that ends the match. Victory! We can't claim that you carried the game, but that was the most damage done in the match. It was also a good example of the Confederate spirit. Well played. Next up, a crucial contribution. Lord JDK from the EU region does everything possible to carry the team on Live Oaks. Let's see how it goes. The matchmaker smiles and Lord ends up in the top bracket. The T-54 First Prototype's engine is a little underpowered, but that doesn't stop it from taking point in the push for the town. This Cromwell seems a little suicidal, and its troubles are soon over. A little while later, another Tier 6 medium charges into close combat. What is it with these guys? The Churchill is the next to fall. This is all going rather well here in the city, but the enemies are breaking through in the south. Surprise! The Tiger II gives some trouble, but that's still two top-tier heavies taken out rather handily. The city is secure, and Lord races back to defend the cap circle. The low-accuracy gun is performing remarkably well at this range. No invader for you, Panther! Lord JDK is playing an amazing game, but the ammunition is starting to run low. The prototype carries only 34 shells, and most of those are now gone. Can the Soviet prototype beat the Chinese copy? Looks like it can! Another one bites the dust, but Lord is down to 80 shells and out of allies. The crew fight to the end, but without proper ammunition, they are doomed. It's a loss, but a heroic one. That really deserved to be a win, and so we'll recognize Lord JDK as the crucial contributor of the week. Maybe leave out the HE shells next time though, And for the last replay, we have a traditional Top Gun Rampage. This time of the autoloader variety. Butter on Toast from the North American region heads on to Westfield and lets the AMX 1390 off the chain. Go get him! Butter sets up an ambush and waits for a suitable victim. This one's a little tough. How about these guys though? That's better. The AMX is a challenging target, but it dies soon enough. Did this type fall asleep? That was a bit of a slow start. 5 minutes in and no kills. You can do better than this, Butter. The next skirmish is pretty intense, and it finally gets Butter the first kill of the match. So there you are, minding your own business and reloading your gun, when a tank charges down the hill out of nowhere! Boy, was that close. 4 shells loaded, and the cap needs to be cleared. Another ally dies, but who needs allies when you're going for the Top Gun? Let the killing spree commence. One down, 5 more to go. And that's the last ally dead. The end game is 1 against 5. The enemy reset the cap themselves, giving Butter time for a reload. Let's see if the capper is still there. Yes it was. Where did the other one go? That artillery support makes this quite dangerous. Well, speak of the devil. Hello there. And another one. Bang! Bang! You as well! Bang! Bang! That's much better. 6 kills and 2 enemies to go. The tank wasn't spotted, so Butter stays in the bush for the reload. The last enemy tank shows itself before it's done, and so does the artillery. Splendid. Both enemies fire, and the SPG misses by a fraction. They do both miss though, and that means the game is over. Victory with 8 kills. Things picked up very nicely after the slow start. A nice Top Gun victory to end this episode on. Congratulations! And that's it for this week. A bunch of awesome games and enough action to sustain you until next time. What should be the secret word for today? Hey, what does the fox say?
Shut up.